I start randomly in a porter cabin with a box marked Islington, which is where I live. This is my video shop. This is my dry cleaners. These are doorways in my neighbourhood, and this is what someone's written on them.
All of these archive boxes here are mainly photographic research for Eyes Wide Shut. Everything from doorways to street scenes. Cafes. And apartment interiors.
It's like the whole of London is in this porter cabin.
I mean, there's a whole box there full of gates, you know, estate gates.
For one scene in
Eyes Wide Shut. For one scene, yeah.
Did you do this on all the films?
Yeah.
Who were the photographers?
I think most of the London stuff was done by Manuel Harlan, Jan's son. In fact, you can see there it says Manuel, EWS, Eyes Wide Shut.
So how many photographs did you take?
I don't know. I can't remember. 30,000? Was a number I arrived at once.
So how long were you traipsing through London for?
A year.
Really, a year? Every day?
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Did you feel like it was a good year?
Yeah, I thought it was a great year, actually. Originally, I was just going to do some stately homes, and then suddenly I found myself looking for coffee shops, and then doorways that could be, you know, the hooker's doorway where Tom meets the prostitute.
And you took some hooker doorway photographs on my street, which I thought was both exciting but also a bit of a kick in the teeth.
Oh, really? Stanley was always keen on getting sort of the sort of detritus of people's lives. So he loved me sort of getting sort of bedside tables with sort of, you know, drying socks and a radio alarm clock and a sort of a Mickey Mouse light or something like that. And he'd say, no art department would ever make this. You know, it's so bizarre that you'd never think of it.
She shot a lot of toy shops as well.
Yeah, toy shops, mortuaries. Oh, costume places. That was a really long job, actually. I was in every costume shop in the southeast of England.
And did he look at them all?
All, with tremendous excitement. Yeah, there was a time when I would get, you know, three or four phone calls a day saying, you know, what are you doing? Have you found anything good yet? And, you know, what's this place like? And he had such a charisma that you wanted to please him.
Would he not be overwhelmed by the amount of things he'd have to then look through?
No. I would say he was rarely overwhelmed.
Yeah, he was. I mean, it is true that he was an impatient man, but immensely patient with his work.
Hmm. He had a particular gift, I think, that was a real gift, mm-hmm. in that most people, if they work very constantly, the doors have to be closed, everything has to be quiet, and he could be interrupted all the time. He would immediately go back to whatever it was. Mm. He would refocus very quickly within a second.
Well, there was one time when he wanted me to shoot the whole of Commercial Road from one end of the street to the other. I mean, it's not a short street, but he didn't want the buildings to tilt forward or back. So I had to take a big ladder with my camera, and it's this huge ladder that it was about, you know, 12 foot high, this ladder. And I had to climb to the top of the ladder, shoot a shop front, move the ladder on 12 feet, climb it again, shoot another shop front, and then eventually be able to, you know, stick together with sellotape a long, long, sort of literally 6 meter row, photographs.